I've never had a film at the London Film Festival before, so it's great. And also I've got loads of relatives and friends who I can finally get to show the film, which is brilliant. It's based on the book I'm Not a Serial Killer by Dan Wells, and it's a story about a teenager played by Max Records growing up in a small town in middle America, who basically spots that somebody's killing people in the town, and his mum runs the town mortuary, so he helps with the embalming. So he, like a kind of teenage Sherlock Holmes, begins to investigate, but it's complicated by the fact that he himself has been diagnosed with sociopathic tendencies, so it gets very complicated between him hunting the killer and what it's bringing out in himself. The main cast, as I was saying, is John Cleaver, the main kid in it, is played by Max Records, who you might have seen when he was nine. He was in Where the Wild Things Are, the Spike Jonze film. And then his neighbour is played by Christopher Lloyd, obviously Doc Brown from Back to the Future. And his mum is played by Laura Fraser, you've probably seen in Breaking Bad and things. That's the main cast. And then we cast a lot locally in Minnesota, where we shot the film, with some brilliant actors from there and from non-actors who were really good as well. So it was really good.
Overall, what are you most hoping an audience takes away from the film when they get a chance to see it?
Well, it's a supernatural thriller that sort of has a strong vein of black humor. So I love sitting with an audience in a cinema, watching it big, and just hearing people laugh and then scaring them as well. It's great. So that's just, I get a real buzz out of that, you know. It's really good.
What do you think is unique or special about the London Film Festival?
I think it's position. We're in an English speaking country, obviously, but it spans both Europe and now the world and English language cinema. So it's the mixture of that in a city the size of London. So it's got a real buzz about having films from all over the world. Basically, I think that's what's really cool about it. It was sort of contained excitement, I guess, and especially because so many of these films have never been seen before. You know, like a few of them probably launching in Toronto in a few couple of weeks' time, but other than that, a lot of them I'd never seen before. So there's a real air of anticipation about it, I think, which is very exciting. Well, it's vital because obviously the main, you know, a lot of the main American films these days are superhero films, and so a chance to get to see the odd and the unusual and the different is vital to have a healthy kind of film world, and they teach us so much about the world as well, you know, and they're great fun, so it's cool.